A former senator chiming in on the rift between the Dutertes and President Marcos. Antonio Trillanes IV now calling on Vice President Sara Duterte to resign as Education Secretary of the Marcos cabinet. In a post on X, he said, VP Duterte should be ashamed of the chaos that her father and brother instigated by insulting President Marcos. Sara Duterte was one half of the Uniteam coalition during the 2022 election that she and the president won.
The Philippine government revises to 6% the country's economic growth rate in the third quarter of 2023. That was slightly up from the previously reported 5.9%. Now, the Statistics Bureau says the revision reflects changes in the manufacturing and financial sectors, among others. The move comes ahead of the release on Wednesday of the fourth quarter and full year growth figures for 2023. First Metro Investment expects the economy to grow by 5.5% in the said year, falling short of the government's target range of 6 to 7%. Now this year, First Metro projects an expansion rate of 6%. Philippine Finance Chief Ralph Recto holds bilateral talks with a visiting U.S. State Department official on strengthening economic ties between Manila and Washington. The visiting American official, Undersecretary for Economic Growth, Energy and Environment, Jose Fernandez, highlighted specific areas of interest like critical minerals, semiconductors, and energy security. Secretary Recto expressed willingness to collaborate on these areas. He also reassured Washington of the Philippine government's strong resolve to address investor concerns like high electricity costs. Meanwhile, in another meeting, Secretary Recto lauded the Securities and Exchange Commission for its digitalization initiatives. He urged the SEC to team up with the Bureau of Internal Revenue for efficient data sharing and reconcile records of registered corporations, enhancing tax collection efficiency. The latest now on President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s state visit to Vietnam, Manila and Hanoi signed agreements to increase cooperation on rice trade and maritime security in the South China Sea. The Memorandum of Understanding on Rice Trade Cooperation creates a framework to ensure and establish sustainable food supply amid the impact of climate change and other factors. Vietnam agreed on a five-year trade commitment to supply white rice to the Philippine private sector of up to 2 million metric tons per year. President Marcos also saw the signing of an MOU on incident prevention and management in the South China Sea.
We now have agreements that we had discussed in more and more detail as our meetings progress. I'm grateful for the opportunity to look into further the ever-evolving relations between our two countries. Our discussions on the sidelines of the past three ASEAN. I have another chance to meet with you now and explore the progress in the relations between Vietnam and the Philippines. I'm honored to have the opportunity to visit this beautiful country.
Marcos also met with top executives of Vietnam's largest conglomerate, Vingroup, which is looking to invest in the Philippines' electric vehicle battery production. Marcos told them the Philippines can support production with its skilled workforce and its mineral reserves, nickel, cobalt, and copper, all of which are critical components of batteries. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are pointing to a positive open after Monday's flat close. A packed day awaits traders with GDP reports coming out of Germany and the Eurozone. France already reported its output in the fourth quarter stagnated as domestic demand fell. Stateside now, futures are flat as investors brace for earnings from Microsoft and Alphabet. So let's go check on financial markets close to home. Asian shares mostly higher after an overnight Wall Street rally with both the Dow and S&P 500 ending at records to kick off a heavy news week that includes tech titan earnings and a Federal Reserve interest rate decision. Taking a look at the board now, the Nikkei 225 is up 0.1% after Japan's unemployment rate fell to 2.4% in December from November's 2.5%. This also comes as Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida vows to do everything possible to boost household income in a policy speech on Tuesday. The Japanese leader also said that his administration's biggest mission is to revive the economy. Chinese markets, meanwhile, are in the red, still dragged by worries over the liquidation order against embattled property firm China Evergrande.
Anchors and reporters of suspended TV network SMNI seek a reprieve from the country's highest court. They filed petitions for a temporary restraining order and injunction against the cease and desist order of the National Telecommunications Commission, which caused the suspension of SMNI's operations. They insist they are fighting for press freedom. The media arm of controversial televangelist Apollo Quiboloy had defied an earlier 30-day suspension over alleged violations of its franchise. SMNI has been under fire for allegedly spreading misinformation and for airing a death threat by former President Rodrigo Duterte on one of its shows. Telco giant Globe continues its campaign against financial fraud. The company says the number of bank-related spam and text scams that it blocked last year were significantly down by 73.7%. This reflected to nearly 22 million intercepted incidents of such versus the 83 million in 2023. Globe says this shows its commitment to combat financial fraud and is also a call for it to continuously enhance its security measures. The telco has invested some $20 million to filter out unwanted messages for its customers.
Our numbers that matter today, 494 billion pesos, that's the value of production in the Philippine farming and fishery sectors in the last quarter of 2023. This was an increase of 0.7% year on year. Government attributes this to higher value of crops, livestock, and poultry. Crop production remained the biggest contributor to total output at 290 billion pesos. This was followed by livestock and poultry. Fisheries, though, contracted by 5.2%.